Architecture shapes our culture, our identities, our way of life, and even our understanding of the cosmos. It continues to shape our current reality, just as it shaped our reality for thousands of years. To know who we are today requires that we know who we were. For as William Faulkner once said, the past is never dead, it's not even past. Some buildings are admittedly in ruins or have disappeared altogether, but buildings have amazing longevity. Even buildings that are hundreds and thousands of years old can still serve as living elements in our culture. We no longer build pyramids, of course, but the pyramids are certainly a permanent element in our cultural imagination. In this course, I've picked out some important moments in the history of architecture that, if you begin to add them together, constitute a global perspective. First societies still exist in many parts of the world. We, as modern and agriculturalists, our history is only 5,000 years. The buildings I talk about place architecture in the dynamics of history. Someone had to make the first pyramid. Someone had to design the first church or the Buddhist temple. Someone had even to design the first teepee. Architectural history is filled with moments of transition and innovation, brought on by changes in power, religion, trade, ecology, and techniques of production. We will start with the architecture of our first society ancestors, some 150,000 years ago, and take the story to about 1400 CE, to the doorstep of our modern age. But in all cases, we are talking about buildings that shaped our modernity in one way or another.
So the caves, these are not cave people. They're not living in the caves. The caves are the sacred places of discourse, if you will, with animals and ancestors.
I will cover some buildings that might be well known, but just as many that might be new to you if you are coming to architectural history for the first time. Having visited many of these places myself over the years, I want to try to bring some of the excitement of these buildings into the classroom as they are part of our global civilizational legacy. In these lectures, I try to give you the context of the buildings. I'll try to give you also the larger geopolitical story and frame architecture within that. I also try to explain how buildings function, which is not just a question of how they're used, but how buildings evoke or even model certain imaginaries, which I think is an important part of how architecture works and why buildings are such exciting things to study.